everyone. It's Tuesday. Good morning. Good morning. Here is my shirt that I got from Disney World without going to Disney World. Anyway, I'm headed off to work and I'm just going to show you guys what I'm having for breakfast, lunch, and snack. First of all, over here, these are not for breakfast, lunch, or snack, but these are the ice cubes I've been making. I am using this Lipton peach mango tea. I use 2 tea bags to 8 ounces of water and then just let it steep for as long as possible and then squish the tea bags out really well. And these are actually really flavorful. I have been having these in the evening in place of the sugar-free popsicles. To me, they are like munching on sugar-free popsicles, but without the points and without any artificial sweeteners. So they're really good. I'm kind of hooked. So I'm making more of these for tonight or whenever the mood strikes. Anyway, let me show you how easy it is for me at the moment to do my breakfast, lunch, and snack for work. Because what I do, here's my planner, and I just wrote it all down here. So I have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc., and then I have breakfast on the top, lunch, and then snack. So basically, I look at Tuesday, okay, peanut butter, banana, oatmeal, pizza wrap, tomato soup, string cheese, and fruit. And I literally just go and grab it out of the fridge because it's all completely ready and it's done. And then I also have like the points total on the bottom here, which did not include coffee because I forgot that I'm using a point for my coffee now. So, but anyway, it's super easy just to glance at my planner, grab the stuff, and then go. So here's what I have for today. I have breakfast is going to be coffee, of course. Coffee, I'm now using 3 tablespoons of the fat-free half and half for 1 smart point. I'm really enjoying the flavor of just my coffee tasting like coffee, so no sweeteners and no artificial flavors. I actually really was nervous about trying this fat-free half and half. I drug my feet for a while and I don't know why, because it's perfect. It makes it, that's 3 tablespoons and it's nice and creamy. I brew my coffee on strong. But 3 tablespoons is perfect. So 1 smart point for the coffee. And then I'm also having my peanut butter banana oatmeal for breakfast this morning. In the jar is a quarter cup of oatmeal for 2 smart points, a half cup of almond milk for 0 smart points, 2 sweetener packets for 0 smart points, a quarter cup water, and 2 tablespoons of PB Fit for 1 smart point. So I have 3 smart points in the jar for the peanut butter banana oatmeal. And then when I get to work and heat it up is when I add the banana, because I don't actually like the banana cooked in there. I like it when the banana is fresh and just dropped in. So that is my oatmeal for 3 smart points. So breakfast is 4 smart points altogether. Lunch today is my pizza wrap, which I'm very excited to try. Somebody asked me how I roll those wraps up, and this is the wrap that exploded because I had too much stuff in there, but we'll make it work. I'm gonna heat this up for probably 30 seconds just to get the cheese a little melty, and then this is an Olay wrap on the bottom for 1 smart point, and then I have 1 tablespoon of fat-free cream cheese for 0 smart points. I have 13 turkey pepperoni for 1 smart point, and then I have sliced onion, sliced bell pepper, and then a quarter cup of Kraft fat-free cheddar for 0 smart points. So this pizza wrap altogether is 2 smart points. And then with that, I'm having a jar of the fire roasted diced tomatoes. These are 0 smart points straight out of the jar. I love the flavor of these, so I just eat them like a soup. So I'm eating these on the side with my pizza wrap. So lunch today is 2 smart points. For snack, I was going to have string cheese, but yesterday I found I'm not really a huge fan of that and it's not worth the 1 measly point. So I'm gonna stick with fruit. I really enjoy fruit for my snacks. I like fruit and Jell-O and yogurt, and that's about it at the moment until I find something else that's low points for my snacks. So for my snacks today, I'm having grapes, 0 smart points, and then the Hungry Girl scoopable apple pie that I did not have yesterday, 0 smart points. So altogether, I have 4 smart points for breakfast, 2 smart points for lunch, and 0 for snack. That is 6 points total for my day so far. Hi guys, morning walk break, morning check-in. Walking kind of fast because super busy this morning already. Good busy though. I had like an, gosh, it was like an hour long chat with my boss about Gina Davis and how she's advocating for more women in Hollywood and in the workplace in general. Anyway, it was a good conversation. Out of breath, walking fast. I can tell you already that I am not gonna be able to run 7.6 miles an hour at my lunchtime run. When I was going up the stairs to work today, my legs were just super tired, so there's no way it's happening. I'm kind of bummed about that, but I need to just rethink my whole workout plan. Instead of just forcing the speed, I need to really get on a plan, an interval training plan, something that's gonna really help me see improvement instead of just magically forcing myself. I think it's kind of cool. You can force your body to do what you want it to do to a point. And then you have to get smart about it and you have to use science and all that good stuff. So that's where I'm at. I just had my oatmeal about half an hour ago, the peanut butter banana oatmeal is typically very filling, and today was no surprise. I love it, love it, love it. And only 3 points, so. You know what I'm really missing is apples. Apples and salad. Got leaves in my shoes. Apples and salad are the two things that I have not added back in since the whole big stomach debacle. I'm really paranoid about salad because I think I was eating that huge giant tub of salad the whole week that I had the stomach problem. So I'm really paranoid that, number one, it was either something in that salad, or number two, it's just salad in general or too much salad. Anyway, I miss apples. I think I'm gonna have an apple maybe sometime this week. Anyway, not much to chat about yet, but I will check in with you guys. I'm gonna do my 3 mile run at lunch. I'll do my afternoon walk break. And tonight is weigh-in, so I'm feeling pretty positive about weigh-in. I feel pretty cute and pretty tiny today, so that's always good. Regardless, I'm not wearing leggings, and I always wear black leggings when I weigh in. So I'm not wearing leggings, and I need to remember that if the scale doesn't say what I think it should, it might just be clothing. We'll see. I'll let you guys know when I find out. Talk to you later. Okay guys, 3 miles on the treadmill, done. That last mile was really hard. Last mile was at 7 miles an hour. Part of the problem is that my earbud died, so I couldn't listen to my audiobook, so it was a lot harder to zone out. So my mantra, no thinking, just doing. It was hard. The gym is empty today, just the way I like it. So, no rowing for me. I gotta go shower and head back to work. Hi guys, second walk break. Checking in. I totally forgot to change my shoes. So I walked over here in heels. They are wedges, but still, they're not the best for walking. Thankfully, I have a spare pair at work. I'll be changing as soon as I get back. I wanted to tell you guys that that pizza wrap was perfection. It was awesome. Just adding the sliced bell pepper and the sliced onion was perfect. I heated it in the microwave for 30 seconds. The cheese was all melty and yummy. The bell pepper was still crisp. I would say that just be careful and don't add too much onion, because I get heartburn from raw onion, and the onion was like just barely zapped, so pretty much raw. So I need to keep the onion thin, but it was perfect. The only thing that would have made it better is if I had some marinara sauce to dip it in, but I did not want to take the points hit for spaghetti sauce. Also, I thought we had a jar and we didn't. Next time I make that, I'm gonna make my own marinara sauce. I'll probably just take a little tomato sauce and add some garlic and Italian seasoning so I have something to dip it in. But even without that, it was perfect. 2 points. I am so happy with all of my wraps right now. Like literally, once I add the sliced apple and pear back to my turkey wrap, that will be a favorite again. So I've got my turkey wrap for 1 smart point. I have my egg wrap for 1 smart point. I got a pizza wrap now for 2 smart points, and a peanut butter banana wrap for 2 smart points. That's a lot of variety and a lot of really filling low points wraps. So I am so thankful for those Olay wraps. Anyway, I need to hobble back to work, and got lots of stuff going on. I'm trying to plow through some things, and it feels like I never get to my filing, so I have so much filing to do. I'm gonna go back to work and do that right away. But yes, it is 90 degrees out here too, like crazy. I feel so bad for you guys, Beckys. I haven't even had a chance to check the news, so I don't know if you got that big snowstorm. But if you did, I feel so bad for you, because it's March. We should not be having blizzards in March, right? I also think that 90 degrees is too much for March. But Mother Nature does not want to give us any kind of happy medium. So here we are, and I'd rather take 90 degrees than a blizzard. Anyway, catching my breath for a minute. I feel great. I feel really good right now. I feel satisfied. Weighing is tonight. Hopefully the scale likes me. Talk to you guys later. You guys! I'm so excited! I just can't hide it! I know, that was terrible. I'm so excited. So, number one, I have an in-person interview with Weight Watchers, the territory manager, tomorrow! So, yay! Super excited about that. Number two, I am going to go zip lining for the first time ever in my life. I've been wanting to do this forever. I am going zip lining at Gatorland in Florida. I'm so scared, but I'm super excited. Anyway, just had to share, I am on the way to Weight Watchers, and I just missed my turn. Now I gotta go to the next exit. I'm just so excited. I will check in with you guys after weigh-in and let you know how it goes. Bye. Alrighty, just good news all around. Happy Tuesday to me. So weigh-in was awesome. I am down 2.2 pounds, which puts me at 132.2, which puts me at 39 pounds lost total. Yay! I'm so happy! If you've been following me, you know that I tend to go up and down quite a bit. So I could be down 2.2 this week and be up 3 next week. It's the way I roll, it's how my body works. But for now, I'm super excited. I'm very happy to be down 2.2. And you know what? I don't think it's a fluke. I think I earned it this week, because not talking about, okay, everything besides that Wednesday cheese and wine fest has been pretty good. The Wednesday cheese and wine fest was 114 big points. But pretty much every other day since then has been fairly mellow. Even the days that I'm not at 30 points or 30-ish points, I didn't go that far over, not like I typically do. So It's been a good week. I feel like I reined it in quite a bit after that cheese and wine day. And so maybe that helped pay off. I did my workouts as scheduled. Actually, I think I only had 3 workouts last week, so that's really odd. Although I have always said that workouts do not help me lose weight. They do help me maintain, and they help me in many, many other ways, but running has never made me lose weight. Even when I was training for marathons, running insane miles. So that is interesting though, that I expected on a higher mileage week to have lost, but I'm not gonna argue with that. So down 2.2, 132.2. I'm super excited. My lowest weigh-in so far has been 131.8. And a few weeks ago, there was some discussion and thought about whether or not I should keep my ultimate goal weight at 130 pounds or raise it to 135. So I decided to let that 130 go, and 135 is my ultimate goal weight still. However, given the fact that I am going on vacation in a week and a half, and I'm going to be gone for 11 days, definitely out of my comfort zone. I do eat out a lot. We eat out a lot on the weekends. We've kind of toned it down a little bit, but we do eat out every single weekend, several times on the same weekend. So I'm not afraid of eating out. It's just the fact that it's going to be 11 days of I need to be really consistent about making good decisions and doing the research and planning where I can. So it's going to involve a lot of work. I think it would be really nice if I could have a little buffer zone so that if I do gain a little bit, you know, I don't want to come back at 140. So in the back of my mind, I'm kind of thinking for this week and whatever I have of next week, I'm going to still try and just keep it really mellow. I cannot put severe restrictions on myself because, as we saw last week with the elimination diet, my phone just about died. As we saw last week with when I tried to do the elimination diet, So last week when I tried to do the elimination diet, I cannot restrict that severely because it backfires on me and then I end up with a huge 114 point binge. So what I want to do this week is just kind of keep things as mellow as possible and not go crazy super high in points. My goal is always to keep it around 30-ish, so I'm going to try for 30-ish again and just see how many days I can do that. So yeah, that's my goal for this week. I just want to keep things in my lower range. I'm not asking for perfection. I'll never be perfect at this. Never. One day I'm at 10 points and most days I'm at 60 points. So I'm never going to be perfect at this, but my goal this week is to have more 30-ish range days. So anyway, I am headed home and we are having chicken for dinner. Eddie was kind enough to make spaghetti squash for me. I appreciate every time he does one of those, every time he cuts open those big squash and scoops the stuff out. And he says it's not a pain in the butt, but to me it's a pain in the butt. So I truly appreciate every time he does that for me, especially when he's not going to eat it. So Eddie has made a spaghetti squash for me, and I'm going to top that with fire roasted tomatoes, which are zero. Spaghetti squash is zero, and I'm going to have 5 big ounces of chicken for 3 points. Have you guys ever, I think most people when they eat grilled chicken, they eat about 3 to 4 ounces, which is 2 smart points. I go for 5 because 5 ounces is super filling for super low points. So I can pair those 5 ounces, 3 measly points with lots of low points vegetables, or even, I mean, what's 3 points? I can pair that with baked potato or pasta, but I just find that the full 5 ounces is very, very satisfying to me. So that's what's for dinner. I will show you guys what it looks like when I get home and get it set up. Here is my perfect dinner tonight. Eddie did such a good job. Everything is just perfect. This is my 3 smart point dinner, and you can see it's a very, very full plate. So this is going to be very filling. On the bottom, I have spaghetti squash for 0 smart points. On top of that, I have covered it with these fire roasted diced tomatoes, which, yes, I also had for lunch and which I love. I didn't expect to have them twice in one day, but I'm totally okay with that. So those are 0 points as well. And then I also have 5 ounces of chicken, just grilled chicken breast, for 3 smart points. And on top of the chicken, Eddie cooked it with this everything but the bagel sesame seasoning blend. And this is so good. I love it. I already tasted the chicken and it tastes fabulous. So it's perfect on chicken for starters. I don't know what else I'm gonna use it for, but I feel a lot of ideas coming on. It's so good. So my entire plate is only 3 smart points, and that only puts me at 9 smart points for the day. But have no fear, because here is the wine to the rescue. I have my 2 8-ounce glasses of wine. 1 8-ounce glass is 7 smart points. So that is 14 smart points together. And that still puts me at, what is that, 24 smart points for the day? Somewhere thereabouts. I just totally lost track. So anyway, there's dinner for 6, oh my gosh. There's dinner for 3 smart points and 14 for the wine. Okay guys, that dinner was so perfect. And not just because it's super low points. I actually like that dinner just for the flavor of it too. The pasta or the spaghetti squash is so filling, and the fire roasted tomatoes are so yummy. And then the seasoning on that chicken just took everything over the top. The seasoning is like a little crunchy. It's so good. That's perfect. That is one of my favorite dinners, and it's only 3 smart points. And just thank you so much to Eddie who cooked all of it. So that was awesome. I am ending my day right now at 23 smart points. So happy with that. I may actually have another glass of wine because I have the points. I just don't know if I'll be up that late. So I'm gonna try and get this video uploaded right now and head to bed. But right now I'm at 23 points, so I'm probably not going over for today either. It's a miracle, 2 days in a row. And I also ended at like 14,600 steps. So a very, very good day for me. I hope you guys all had a great Tuesday as well, and I will check in with you tomorrow. Hello, Eddie.
Oh, hello. I'm on video now?
Yes, you're on video.
Oh, this is just a reminder. Don't skip the ads. Don't skip the ads. Don't skip the ads. So tomorrow when you see that ad come up, don't hit the skip button, just let it play through.